Welcome to an enlightening podcast from IslamPodcasts.com. We encourage our listeners to please comment and let us know how we can grow in our knowledge to better serve our community. Please remind your family and friends to also visit IslamPodcasts.com for engaging discussions on current events, Islamic guidance, Quran, tafsir, seerah, and much more.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة، فتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بلزوم أمر الله ولزوم طاعته، فمن عمل بوصيتي فلنفسه ومن أساء فعليها، وما ربك بظلام للعبيد. أما بعد، dear brothers in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. When Allah سبحانه وتعالى sent the deen of Islam, the deen of mercy, the final deen, the final way of life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted for humanity, accepted for humans to go and live accordingly in order to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that there will be difficulties. There will be tests when doing this. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was engaged in calling the people for Islam, engaged in delivering the message of Islam to the people on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he struggled. The Sahaba struggled. And they saw these difficulties in front of their hands, in front of their eyes. They lived it. And they used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looking for advice, complaining to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is not something new. This is part of carrying the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All prophets before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they all struggled for this deen. And we personally, in our personal life, we struggle. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises us that after the usr, there is yusr. Inna ma'al usri yusra, inna ma'al usri yusra. After difficulty, there is ease. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising us that, whether it's at our personal life or when it comes to propagating this deen, spreading this light of Islam into this earth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one that's worshipped. The commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the only things that are implemented, not the man-made laws. My laws, your laws, no, the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that will guarantee the safety and the security and the success in this dunya and the success in the akhirah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives us hope. When there is difficulty, there is hope. I want to share with you some incidents from the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and then later from the lives of the khulafa. الراشدين رضي الله عنهم. The خلفاء, the hope that we have. In one incident, خباب بن الأرت, this is at the time when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was in Mecca. In the early days of Islam. And the Muslims and the Sahaba are struggling. And Quraysh is beating them. And is attacking them. And they had enough. خباب بن الأرت comes to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم who was sitting by the Kaaba, and he said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, ألا تستنصر لنا؟ ألا تدعو لنا؟ When you ask Allah to give us victory, ask Allah, make dua to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, so He give us victory. This is at the time of difficulty they have when they were in Mecca, struggling for propagating the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replies and he said, قد كان من قبلكم يؤخذ الرجل فيحفر له في الأرض فيجعل فيها، ثم يؤتي بالمنشار فيوضع على رأسه فيجعل نصفين، ويمشط بأمشاط من الحديد ما دون لحمه وعظمه ما يصده ذلك عن دينه. That the ones before you who were carrying their deen, carrying the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the people used to take them and dig a hole for them in the ground, and they put them, and then they come with a comb that's made out of metal, and they rip their meat flesh out with the bones, from the bones. This is what used to happen to them, and they were steadfast on that. They were steadfast on carrying that deen. They were steadfast on carrying that message. ما يصده ذلك عن دينه. That doesn't turn him away from his deen. Look at the price. The price that a hole is dug for you. Your flesh, your meat is taken away from your bone. You're dead. You've been severely punished. Torture. Imagine that. You're dead. The Prophet ﷺ said, those people, this level of punishment was not turning them away from their deen. Wallah. So this is the reality. This is what was happening to the people who were holding firm on their deen. Whether it's before the time of the Prophet ﷺ or at the time of the Prophet ﷺ. Then comes the hope. It's a reality, a harsh reality. Very difficult reality. Then there comes the hope. Wallah, the Prophet ﷺ says, but by Allah, لَيُتِمَّنَّ اللَّهُ هَذَا الدِّينَ حَتَّى يَسِيرُ الرَّاكِبُ مِنْ صَنْعَاءِ إِلَى حَضْرَمُوتِ لَا يَخَافُ إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَالذِّئْبَ عَلَى غَنَمِهِ. By Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to complete this message, is going to complete this deen, and is going to spread it. So the traveler from Yemen, all the way to Hadramaut, from Sana'a to Hadramaut, from Al-Yemen to Al-Sham, to Bilad al-Sham, he will be traveling safely, and he will be just afraid of his sheep, from the wolf on his sheep, natural. So safety. No one is going to come and kill him. No one is going to come and take his stuff. No one is coming to come rob him. No one is coming to come and do anything to him. This deen is going to be spread. This is the hope that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave it to Khabbab radiyallahu anhu and the Sahaba at the moment when they were in severe harsh difficulty. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam continues and says, وَلَكِنَّكُمْ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ. But you rush things. You want things to go very fast. You believed in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and in the message of Islam. And then you want a state to be established right away and the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala implemented without a struggle. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ. You're rushing things. You don't want the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take its place, to take its time and to continue. You want things. So I believed in Islam, that's it. Islam is implemented. Done. That's what I want. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَلَكِنَّكُمْ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ. So the hope that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to the Sahaba at the moment of difficulty, that no, see, you are afraid for yourself now. You are scared for yourself. You are scared for your family. Now, this is the reality. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to make this deen. He's going to make this deen prevail. And you will have safety and you will have security and you will have everything that you need. But don't rush things. Let things take its course. This is at the time in Mecca, when the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was just in the hearts of the people. It's an example. In Al-Madinah, when the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was in the hearts of the people and implemented in Al-Madinah, and the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are implemented. And in Al-Khandaq, the battle of the trench, when the people, when the Muslims were again in a situation, and it's again in a situation where they were fearing for their life. You have the Ahzab, Quraysh, and all the armies around, surrounding Al-Madinah. إِذَا بَلَغَتُ الْقُلُوبُ الْحَنَاجِرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about it. The fear in the hearts of the Muslims, as if their hearts have been all the way up here out of the fear, out of fear that they will be destroyed and finished. That's the situation that they were in. That's the situation. The Muslims decided to go and dig a trench. And when they were digging, Salman al-Farisi faced an obstacle. A big rock. He could not destroy it. He could not break it. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam comes and asks, let me try. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he takes it and he says, Allahu Akbar, and he makes the first hit. A light comes, it cracks. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, Allahu Akbar, qusur al-Sham wa Rabb al-Ka'ba. Look at the time of difficulty. At the time where there is no safety, they don't feel they safe. At the time where they fear their life. At the time where they are in Islamic state. Al-Madinah, the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is implemented. With the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they're fearing their life. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after seeing this light and that crack, he says, Allahu Akbar. Glory to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qusur al-Sham, the palaces of Sham. Wa Rabbu al-Ka'bah. By the Rabb of Al-Ka'ba, by the Lord of Al-Ka'ba. He's giving them the hope and the promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the palaces of Al-Sham will be under the rule of Islam. At the moment where they were fearing for their life, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving them the hope. Then he hits it the second one. He says, Bismillah, and then he hits the second one. Same thing, light comes up and it cracks again. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Allahu Akbar, Qusur Faris wa Rabb al-Ka'ba. Allahu Akbar, the palaces of Faris, the palaces of Persia, wa Rabb al-Ka'ba. At the time of difficulty, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the Muslims that the hope. This is a moment of difficulty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take care of, but it will take its course. Look in the future. Look at the hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you. The hope is for them when they were sieged in Al-Madinah, that hey, the palaces of Al-Sham and the palaces of Persia will be under your rule, will be under Islam. At the moment when you have what? You're scared for your life. This is the hope that Islam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives it to us. At the moments of difficulty, all what you need to do, stick to the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stick to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And leave it to the future to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised you with everything. He's the one who takes care of everything. Keep it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who takes care of that. Let's look also. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he promised the Muslims that Al-Qustantiniyya, it's going to be conquered and it's going to be ruled by Islam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam living in Al-Madinah, thousands of miles away from Constantinople, Istanbul right now. And he comes and he tells the Muslims, this is in Hadith Al-Imam Ahmad, لَتُفْتَحَنَّ الْقُسْطَنْطِينِيَّةِ Constantinople is going to be conquered. فلنعم الأمير أميرها ولنعم الجيش ذلك الجيش. He's sitting in Al-Madinah with 2,000, 3,000 of the armies of the Muslims, whatever the number is, and he tells them, Constantinople, the capital of the Byzantines, the biggest city, is going to be conquered. And the best leader, its leader. ولنعم الأمير أميرها. And the best army will be that army. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it's going to be conquered. So the Muslims competed. Who's going to be that leader? Who's going to be that army? And they continuously, because this is a promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are wahi. Promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muslim leaders were looking who is going to be the one who will be the best leader. Muslim armies were looking to be the one who is going to be the best army. And they were attacking it. At whether at time of Muawiyah, at the time of Harun al-Rashid, at time of Bayezid, everyone wants to take that honor because they know it's going to be a reality. Promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be a reality. And Muhammad al-Fatih, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, on his hand, he was the one who conquered it. And he did many preparations for that in order to be able to conquer it. And by the way, the anniversary of conquering Constantinople was just 2 weeks ago. 2 weeks ago. Now, let's look at our situation as an ummah. Where are we? We look at our situation, we're like Khabbab ibn al-Arat, who came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at the Muslims everywhere. Muslims in India. India. What? The biggest democracy in the world. Now your citizenship needs to be taken away. Your safety is no more. You become someone who doesn't, if he lives there, you have no papers, you have no documents. You're illegal. What are their feels? Their feelings? Their feelings are like the feelings of Al-Khabbab ibn al-Arat. The Muslims in China, their feelings are like the feelings of Khabbab ibn al-Arat. The Muslims in Syria, the Muslims in everywhere, their feelings are like the feelings of Khabbab ibn al-Arat. And the feelings of the Muslims at the Battle of the Trench. But the hope is there. The hope from Allah is there. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes and says, وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised, a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ones who do good. The ones who do good and believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they will be established on this earth. That they will be firmly established on this earth. This is a promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. Don't look at the current situation that you have. Stick to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you will be successful. Then all of this will be history. All of this will be history. This is what we need to look at from these two incidents. That Islam comes and tells you, yes, you live difficult now. You live a difficult life right now. You're faced with challenges right now. But the hope is there. Your hope is there that you will be successful. But for that, you have to stick to the life of Islam, to the life as a Muslim. Don't compromise your deen. Do not compromise your deen. In any way, don't compromise your deen. Because when you compromise, if you compromise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might let you go. And you will not get the success. The hope that's promised, you might not get it. عباد الله أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فيفوز المستغفرون استغفر الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. So dear brothers, when we look at the history, there is lessons for us. And those lessons, whether it's the conquest of Constantinople, the incidents of Khabbab ibn al-Arat, the incidents of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam promising the Muslims when they were sieged at the time of difficulty, at the time where they were not safe for themselves, that you will have the palaces of Asham, you will have the palaces of Persia. That's what we need to keep in our mind. The promise of Allah subhanahu. But to get that promise, we have to work for it. And working for it is simple. Stick to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded you to do. It's going to be a challenge. It's a challenge. And it's difficult. But this is what gets you to the Jannah. This is what gets you to your goal. This is what's going to relieve the insecurity that you have. This is what's going to relieve the difficulties that you have. Other than that, it's difficulty after difficulty, insecurity after insecurity. Away from the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is what we get. Insecurity after insecurity, difficulty after difficulty, without hope that it's going to be relieved at one point. عباد الله، إن الله أمركم بأمر ابتدأه بنفسه وثنى عليه ملائكته فقال: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم، وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم انصر المسلمين بالإسلام وأعز المسلمين بالإسلام، واخذل المشركين أعداءك وأعداء الدين، إنهم لا يعجزونك. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا يا رب العالمين. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اغفر لنا وللمؤمنين أجمعين يا رب العالمين. اللهم وارحمنا وتب علينا يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة.
Thank you for listening to this podcast. Podcasts on current events, Islamic guidance, Quran tafsir, and seerah are available at islampodcasts.com as well as on iTunes. Rate, review, and comment and let us know how we can grow in our knowledge to better serve our community. Please subscribe, share, and tell a friend about islampodcasts.com.